Floyd Mayweather identified as a woman, should he be allowed to compete against other female boxers?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you guys all confidently say yes?
Yes.
Do you think that would be a fair fight?
Yes.
If the organization forced the female boxers to have to compete and they had no choice.
So, Mr. Michael Mann, what should he do?
He probably deserved it, to be honest.
Hello.
Do you think men are stronger than women?
No, I don't think so. I mean, like, they're physically built different.
So do you think men are physically stronger than women?
No, not necessarily.
So you think if your man gets knocked out, you gonna stand a chance?
Yes.
Busta knows how to swing. Uh-huh. I believe her.
They always say, oh, you know, a woman can't beat a man. I spar with men. I drop men. I bust men nose. I beat men up all the time.
Yes.
Oh. Oh, oh, oh. One hit.
Damn.
In an unexpected turn of events, a little boy defied expectations and emerged victorious in a wrestling match against an older and taller girl.
Give all the praises and the honor to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Recha Ha Kodash, and double honors to the elder apostles and elder bishops of Great Millstone. Honors as well to you, brethren, you fellow believers of this faith, even you few sisters, and shalom to the elect. Anyway, I'll try to make this video short. Nothing particularly planned in the commentary, so it just what it is. The delusion of Babylon, Nahum 3:1. The woe to the bloody cities is all full of lies, right? Full of robbery. They've managed to rob your manhood, right? Not the elect, right? But in general, yeah, all of our manhood has been compromised because we're not allowed technically to be real men. But in this truth, we stand as real men of the Lord. And real men, we don't need women to make us men, in other words. Okay, we need the scriptures. The women that we follow is the wisdom. Okay, now, I will say in this video This is not one of those videos where we usurp authority and whip our women's asses. I'm going to have to say that. I've seen that a couple of times. That doesn't give you the right to pound on your woman because you're just mad at her for no reason. I'm going to just say that. But for the most part, we question, why is there even a battle of sexes? Why is there even a fight? Because when you really think of it, the equality comes in man being over the woman, right? There is no such thing as equality. There's never been equality. What makes man and woman great is they follow their order, right? Just like a car, and it has this radio in there to keep him company while he's driving down the street. Now, he doesn't really need it, but he uses it to turn on a radio to give him some comfort. Okay? And then there's a thing of procreation, which we need the woman for. Just saying. But for the most part, we'll get into some etymology for you who haven't seen that or understand that. And we'll get some scriptures in the Bible. Okay? Now, when it comes to these movies and media, it's all witchcraft. This is why these women are saying that they're equal to men. This is why even we see Israelites. This is another reason why I do these videos. There's Israelites who's given women authority to speak, to read the scriptures while they're speaking, to have these concerts and festivals with the women dancing and singing, telling everybody to listen up. You know? And I also say, a lot of this is brought on by men. This is not some new social media fad, by the way. I'm not a young man, and I remember being young, these older jicks was doing that long before the social media came about. I remember getting into it with some young girl. I was young, and it was 3-4 dudes stood around and dared me to hit the girl back that hit me. Now, mind you, I was always told you're never supposed to put your hand on a woman, although these are girls. But nobody ever tells them you're never supposed to put your hand on a man. So you can see this is generational, right? This is a generational sickness, okay? This is gradualism. Over the years, it just manifested. Okay, let's go to Genesis 5 and 2. It says, male and female created he them and blessed them and called their name Adam, right? Which goes back to man or ground, right? In the day that they were created, male and female. Okay, this is why it says male and female. What is a female for? Let's go to Genesis 5. Genesis 2 and 18. And the Lord said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a help meet for him. So we look up this word help meet. You got to go to biblical usages, right? It just says help. Everybody should know what help means. It says, I didn't even read this, a female helper, for which there is a female helper. It also says, let me see here, also what it says. It says secure, which when we go to sucur, let's see how it's pronounced.
Sucker.
Right? Give assistance to aid. Now, when we go to this word female, this is exactly what it says in online etymology. It says she who suckles, right? Who nurtures. Woman, female. Okay? Feminine male, female, she who suckles. To suck. So, I'm not going to go there, but a woman is supposed to nurture when it comes to her man and her children. So if you ask a woman, right, and you ask the average couple and you walk up to them today, this is how degenerate. What's the scripture say in Jeremiah 2? My people have become a degenerate. How they become a strange plant. If you walk up to a couple and say, ask a couple, what's more important in the relationship? The man, well, you got to ask the woman this, right? The woman will say her child. That's what she'll say. So if the child has more importance, which the child does have importance, but you need that man there to protect that child. You need the woman there to protect that child. Now, the child, if you have a son, of course is important because that's the heir. But you must do whatever you can to protect that child. Right? So the importance is the parents to protect the child. But that's not what's being pushed in this society. It's nowhere near on that level of being pushed. Right? Colossians 3:19. It says, husbands, love your wives, right? And do not harsh toward them. It's another translation. Basically, be not bitter towards them. Now, everybody don't understand the mindset of what it is to be a husband and what it is to be a wife. When a wife, there's a lot of things we can't say on when it comes to this. But when a wife gets out of control, a man has his duty to make sure that that part is in control and whatever it takes, if that's what it takes. See, everybody see love in this society as holding hands with the strollers and walking down with the babies and putting out the blanket and, you know, you got the apple and a sandwich and the potato chips. With the picnic basket. That's what they see love is. I'm not saying whatever you want to do with your wife, that's all right. I mean, you're supposed to have some happiness and whatever. The problem in the society is media, movies, influence. It's just the YouTube and the media, TikTok made it a whole lot worse. So now you have a lot of rebellion in relationships. You had a lot of rebellion when it comes to the women. And you have rebellion against the Lord, right, when it comes to the men, okay? And a lot of Jake feel like, you know, I'm over you so I can, you know, just whip your ass. Ah, you're not just supposed to do that for no reason. I'm going to just whip her ass because I'm mad at her. Not supposed to do that because you're one flesh, you know? Just saying. I witnessed Jake do that, okay? 1 Peter 3:17. We've been calling out you Eves though, man. And why? Because you got hold to feminism. Feminism is the worst thing that could have happened. Believe it or not, feminism is not really meant to destroy men. It's meant to destroy families. But the very people that feminism is directed towards is the ones that's hurting. Now you see women talking about they need a man 6 feet tall. He must make $100,000 and he must have a package. You know, he must have all kinds of amenities. Like, it's rare to get a woman. The rarity comes in when you deal with rarity, value comes in rarity. And it's not rare. Women are not rare. Men are rare. Especially real men. So to get a high valued man comes in rarity. I don't know why women claim that they're valuable, because there's 20 to 30 women to each man right now. And that's serious. So I don't know why they go with that. Like they got all these picks of men to go with. This is why it was well known that a man would have more than one wife. Everybody has a problem with that, but only Western world acknowledges that. Right? Well, now it's moved other places, but originally, that was Western world culture. One wife. Anyway, let's go to 1 Peter 3:7. It says, likewise, husbands dwell with them according to knowledge, giving honor unto the weak vessel, unto the wife as the weaker vessel. So, these kind of lessons can go back and forth because you have to have a woman that's willing to be a weaker vessel in order to give honor to. If you're a brother and you feel like that you don't have the patience, you don't have the time to deal with it, because you know whatever woman you get now is going to be on that feminist status, you're in trouble. If that hinders you out of the way, do as Paul say, be like Paul and just deal with none. But understanding, if you're going to get a woman, understanding the work that you're going to have to put in to get her up on that level, but you can't fade in the truth. So it's going to have to be some kind of special circumstance for the Most High to put the Spirit on her through patience to allow her to be patient, by the way, and mainly you be patient. Let me say you first and then her to accept this truth. Even if she's the unbelieving and she knows what you do, the Most High is the only one that can keep her in a special realm of patience, right, to accept that if she really does go for you. So when you read this, we're going into the churches and what Paul was going through, Apostle Paul, what the churches was doing. That's why he said that, husbands, love your wives, be not bitter towards them. When you really go into the understanding of that, they would do one thing wrong and they would cast them off and divorce them. This is what Yahawashah was saying. Don't put them away lest unto adultery. And that's what they were doing. Can you imagine now in 2024? Man, it's a whole new scenario. The name has changed, but the game is still the same, right? It's a little different, especially with social media. Can you imagine the women of Corinth in the church? If they had YouTube and TikTok, oh, man, I couldn't begin to imagine that. That's all I have on that, Shalom.